This is a musical test. Not for you, the listener, but of a hypothesis of mine. I've been a working professional for many years. We, in our area, recently completed, this past weekend, a run of Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker Ballet. But this arrangement by Yun Jai Lee is for reduced orchestra, and in the score indicates that the pas de deux opening should be cello solo instead of soli, the section. And the conditions this time in this particular pit were environmentally unacceptable, in my opinion. The temperature in the pit was so cold that, and I'm wearing a Sundance ribbed, body-hugging turtleneck, and I was freezing. My hands were ice cold, my body was contracted, and I had to play the following in those conditions. Consequently, whether you notice or not, your heart rate increases in an attempt to warm your body when you get unacceptably cold. So your heart rate increasing, you're not only cold, but you're in an agitated state. I mean, in regular circumstances, when your heart rate increases, like after a vigorous exercise, you couldn't sit down and do something very carefully because your body would be shaking and reacting. And what happens is, for a string player or a wind player or a brass player or any other instrument, if your heart is pounding, you cannot control your small motor activity. Principally, as a string player, the vibrato, which is when we color a note by oscillating on top of the note, we depress the string and then we oscillate that pitch rapidly with our arm, our left arm. And we can control the speed of vibrato under normal circumstances. Sometimes we want broad, rich, slow oscillations, and other times we want fairly rapid oscillations, particularly for pianissimo when we're trying to play softly, to color that dynamic. But in these circumstances, in these conditions, and for this particular line written by Tchaikovsky, extremely fast vibrato is counterproductive because it prevents us from developing the direction of the melody. It's rather orgasmic, actually. It's a simple scale descending and then attempting to build back up again and then moves chromatically to the climax. Under these circumstances, which are in my home, in my music room, nice and warm, 74 degrees, I'm not cold, I'm going to play it under these command performance conditions as a live recording. And let's see what happens, specifically to the speed of the vibrato and to the degree that I am able, therefore, to control what I'm doing musically. So here is the Pas de Deux by Tchaikovsky from the Nutcracker.
Thank you.
didn't notice any racing vibrato. Did you? Because my heart wasn't pounding. And this was still a live command performance. So, I think we should check out the conditions under which professionals are expected to perform environmentally.